Hi friends, this time once again I'd welcome you to Shiksha Mantra, and this is the time for our learning. Shiksha Mantra is your real world of learning, so very different kinds of things. So if you have not subscribed this channel yet, so get this channel, be subscribed with all the notifications on, and also you can join my Telegram channel for many of such notes regarding English grammar, and there you'd find my channel in the same name, Shiksha Mantra, and also the route would be given in the description box below. So check it out, visit my channel, and if you like it, obviously you'd have to describe my channel. So let's begin our discussion today. But before the topic that I'm going to disclose you, I would ask you to note down these sentences first. What are these sentences? Rizul closed the door. Here you'd find closed. This is the verb of this sentence. It has a subject, Rizul, and also an object, the door. So with an object, this verb would be considered as a transitive verb. And here we have another sentence, the door closed. So here closed is the verb, it has a subject, the door. But is there an object? Do you find an object here? No, here's no object present in this sentence. So without an object, the verb is considered as an intransitive verb. Now if you look at these two sentences properly, you'd find the same verb close is used once as the transitive verb and then another as intransitive verb. So thus verb close can be used both as a transitive verb and as an intransitive verb. But there's something more interesting than these. The object, the door, is used here as the subject. So the verb is accepting the same noun once as object and then as subject, and that's the speciality of this verb. So what we are going to discuss now, probably you have got it, probably you have got my point if you know this verb, and if you don't, let me disclose our topic today. And our topic is ergative verbs. Yes dear friends, we are going to learn ergative verbs today. But before starting the discussion, I would ask you to have your pen and paper ready to note down the points and to remember them if you don't want to get to my Telegram channel. And if you visit my Telegram channel, obviously you'd get everything there in that channel ready for you. So let's begin our discussion of ergative verbs. The first point that we are going to discuss is the definition. So what is an ergative verb? Ergative verbs are both transitive and intransitive. The object when it is transitive is the same as the subject when it is intransitive. So we have already discussed it. We have already found in our beginning of this presentation that a verb is transitive and intransitive, used in both ways or the ergative verbs. But there's another point. When it is transitive, it accepts the same subject as the object when it is intransitive. So that's the speciality of this verb, and we call this ergative. So there's another example. The wind shook the trees. So shook is obviously the verb. And here also in the second sentence, the trees shook in the wind. Here also shook is the verb. So the same verb in both the sentences. But the point is, the first sentence is a transitive because there's an object, and the second verb is the intransitive as there's no object. But the object of the first sentence, the trees, are used as the object of the subject of the second sentence. So this is the speciality. This is what we call an ergative verb. But this verb is not so simple as we have found it here. We have to remember something more than this. Augative verbs are found in sentences where the verb affects the subject. But the point is how. When you use an augative verb, you have a choice between two or probably more patterns. These patterns allow you to talk about the world in a very different ways. So this the success of using an argative verbs. They let you make your sentence lively. You can use these verbs to talk different ways about the same concept. But how? For example, you can choose to indicate that something just happens, perhaps as a natural occurrence, without indicating that someone or something is responsible for it. Or you can indicate that someone or something is the cause of what happens and so is responsible for it. So it's about response. One thing where you use this verb makes the subject not responsible for the action, and sometimes it makes the subject responsible for the action. So it's about putting the emphasis properly according to your will. So how does it work? We have to compare the examples here. The glass broke and John broke the glass. So in the first sentence, the glass broke, the verb is used intransitively with the subject the glass. So here you can't blame anyone. No one is responsible for breaking the glass. It appears as if it's a natural procedure. If a glass gets hit with something or it just falls down from your hand on the floor, it's going to break and there's no other option. That's why this is only a natural process and no one is responsible for this. But when you say John broke the glass, now the subject John is responsible for breaking the glass, and this time it's transitive. And that's how it shapes an augative verb, lets you to process your thought in very different ways. That's how you can shift the emphasis of the sentence in different ways. That's how you can twist your sentences by using an ergative verb. I think that you got it properly. So we are going to make our discussion a bit deep. So here you'd find a list of some common ergative verbs. This is very important. You have to keep a note of them properly. So these are the verbs like begin, break, change, close, crack, drop, dry, etc., etc. The list is long and you can remember them or you can note them down. So these are the very common ergative verbs. Every time you face them in a sentence, you have to judge if these verbs are used to make the point, that is responsible or not responsible for the action. And our list doesn't stop here. I'm going to get a bit specific. Verbs to do with cooking are often ergative. So when it's the sense of cooking, you get ergative verbs. So what's the list? The list is like this: bake, boil, cook, defrost, freeze, melt, roast, etc. So these verbs of cooking are ergative in sense. And let's begin our discussion a bit deep. Verbs to do with vehicles are often ergative. So in the previous list we have found cooking, and now it's time for vehicles. So back, crash, drive, fly, reverse, run, sail, start, stop, all these verbs, those are related with vehicles, or probably you may say driving, are also very much ergative in their sense. How? I drive the car. The car drives. So the same thing happens. A kite flies. We fly kites. So it happens. When you use them, obviously they would produce an ergative sense, and that would help you to proceed your sentence with a very different ways. So now we have another list, that is some verbs are ergative, but there's a condition, that is with only a few nouns. So these verbs are ergative only when they are used with these nouns. There's also a list, and you'd have to remember this. The verb is, the first is catch. So when catch is ergative, it gets dress, coat, clothes, trousers, these nouns with them. Fire, gun, pistol, rifle, rocket, etc. Play, music, guitar, piano, CD, DVD, ring, bell, alarm, etc. So let's have an example here to get deep into its learning. So here we have two sentences. He rang the alarm. Now the alarm, this noun is used with this verb, and the alarm rang. So this is ergative, but ring is ergative because it's used with this noun alarm. So the verb and the noun, they are combined together to form an ergative sense. So without these nouns, they cannot be ergative, and you have to remember it well. So ergative is something that is very essential. So when we do this when we don't care about the subject, like the sentences we have discussed, that is the alarm rings. We are not very much careful about the subject, but the action is in our focus. The second point, something does the action to itself. So you have found several descriptions of them in the previous discussion. And also, we want to avoid responsibility. When we don't want the action to come on us, like the glass broke, you don't want to put the responsibility on someone. You just want to avoid the responsibility. And you use this ergative verb to serve your purpose. So that's how we use ergative verb. And that's all from ergative verbs. Remember these points. We still have a lot to discuss in this channel regarding different types of verbs, English grammar, and many other things. So if you find this worthy enough to get subscribed, obviously you have the subscribe button below with the bell icon. You can have it pressed and get the notifications whenever a new video is posted in this channel. And for this session, it's time to bid you bye bye.